photograph that you took of Mother was displayed at her canonization mass. What does that mean to you?
It means just the world to me, Annie. I mean, I have to say that was probably the greatest honor of my life. It was a picture that certainly I wouldn't have put a lot of significance to. I remember the sisters in the canonization office reaching out to me a couple of years ago now, the September of 2015, I think, and asking me if they needed help with the canonization image, would I be helpful to them, and would, you know, could they depend on my help? And of course, I wrote back saying I would love to be involved. And that got me thinking of pitching them some photographs that I had of Mother that weren't seen by others. And they were always looking for a picture that maybe not had been out there in the media before, something that was more private that they could actually put out there to the world in an event like that, the beatification or the canonization, that not many people had seen. And so I pitched them a couple of photographs, and I called back after not hearing from them for a few months, and they told me that the image had to be a painting, that the Vatican had required it to be a painting of her official canonization image. So the shift completely changed, so they ended up taking a lot of the photographs that I had pitched them and forwarded it to a painter, Chaz Fagan, who they had selected, I think, through the Knights of Columbus. He had quite a rich history of painting, and he had painted some of the presidential portraits. And he was one of those rare artists that could do beautiful painting and also sculpt in an amazing way. And I haven't found too many sculptors who can paint well, and vice versa, painters who you know, sculptors who can actually paint and painters who can sculpt. So it was incredible, you know, to work with him. And once he had the assignment, I kind of thought to myself, you know, I don't want to get involved, because I know that what it's like to be an artist and to have somebody kind of breathing down your neck or directing you in some way. So I really prayed about it for a couple of days, and I called back Sister Rosanna, and who was heading up the canonization office and some of their affairs with Father Brian, and said that, you know, I was a little bit hesitant to actually reach out to them because I know, you know, what it can be like. And she was a bit concerned at that time that perhaps he wasn't getting the images that they had sent over via Dropbox and other internet ways because of the images being so high in terms of resolution. So I thought, okay, once I prayed about it, I'll give him a call and see if he needs or would want any of my help or interjection in regard to what he was going to paint. And he had the opportunity to really look at whatever had been photographed on Mother through the years, from books and magazines, things that he had seen on the internet. And once I reached out to him, sure enough, he hadn't gotten those files from Sister Rosanna. So I ended up sending him a light drive with a lot of images that I had captured, and some of them were portraits. And so he called me back a couple of days after looking at all the images, and he said, you know, I know exactly what I want to paint. And it wasn't a picture that I would have selected necessarily. It was sort of an understated photograph that I ended up taking of Mother on one of her trips out to the airport. And she was headed from there, I think, out to New York and then back to Calcutta. And in those years, you could walk right up to the gate, and I was photographing Mother with some of the sisters, and I happened to zoom in and take a few pictures that, in retrospect, were a little bit different in terms of the angle and the lighting. And this one picture that Chaz happened to come upon thought that that was the perfect essential kind of photograph that he wanted to paint from, because in his memory of not knowing Mother personally, but thinking of how the world views Mother, was through an image like that. So he was very much receptive to having help in creating the painting. And it's actually a fusing of two of my photographs that he painted from. One is sort of a bust photograph of Mother and her shoulders and hands. And the other, he liked the way her sari was the created patterns and shadow and light that was coming onto her sari in this one picture that I had. So he took the bottom half of her where she's holding the rosary and praying off of that other image and then fused the two of them together. They lined up actually perfect. and ended up painting. And then it was great to be working with him almost on a daily basis. We would call each other and, you know, talk quite at length in regard to mother's coloring, because what he was doing was working from black and white images and trying to transfer them into paint and trying to get mother's right coloring. And mother had a very sort of almost ashen type of complexion. She had a very kind of white complexion and beautiful eyes. They were almost like greenish blue with a hint of like brownish tones in them, but very piercing eyes. So I wanted to make sure that a lot of that was captured. So I sent him like enlargements of her eyes and the coloring of her face that I thought was accurate, because obviously you see a lot of photographs of mother. Certainly she was the most, one of the most famous of our saints in terms of being photographed, aside from John Paul II. But long story short, it was an incredible honor to work with this great painter and creating this image. And it's beyond my dreams of thinking that I could ever be involved with something like that. In fact, it brought me right back to being a young boy and getting a book from my godmother at First Communion on the saints, and just pouring through that book as a young boy, concentrating on the faces of the saints and, you know, wondering what they would have been like. And now thinking years later that I would have been involved with, you know, somebody's, an actual saint's official canonization image, is really beyond my comprehension. But it's certainly the honor of my lifetime. Mm-hmm.